Dear students, let's discuss one of the most important section in this chapter, that is the characteristics of electric line of forces. We have recently discussed about the electric line of forces, which gives us the idea about the net electric field of the system. There are some specified characteristics you must keep in mind. The very first is, which is quite important, that is two electric line of forces can never intersect in the region of electric field. It's quite obvious because if say an electric line is like this and other electric line is going in this direction, and say we consider at a point these are intersecting, then at this point due to this electric line, electric field will be in this direction, which is say E1 vector, and due to another electric line, electric field which is always along tangent will be in this direction. And at one point in the region of electric field, there will be two directions, which is not possible. Because at any point in an electric field, there exists only one direction of electric field. So whenever such situation arises, automatically the electric line of force configuration get modified. And finally, there will be only one electric line of force at the point P, where we are assuming it is intersecting. Soon we'll discuss some examples which will make it more clear. Another important point which is also useful, that is, it is a convention which is considered for electric line of forces. We can write that conventionally, electric line of forces originate from a positive charge or infinity and terminate on a negative charge or infinity. This is quite a useful and important point to be always kept in your mind. That is, if there is a positive charge, we know that the electric field always exists in radial outward direction. So electric lines, we always consider these are originated from the charge in radially outward direction. These are going up to infinity because electric field due to these lines exist, due to this charge exists up to infinity. So we consider all electric line of forces in the surrounding are originated from positive charge and these are terminated at infinity. Similarly, if there is a negative charge, we know that in the surrounding of a negative charge, electric field exists in radially inward direction. That means the electric lines in its surrounding will be in radially inward fashion. And all these lines are originated from infinity. And finally, these are absorbed by the negative charge, or we say these are terminated on a negative charge. So always the fashion of electric lines are like, from a positive charge, these are originated and these move to infinity. And in the surrounding of a negative charge, we can say these electric lines are terminating or absorbed by a negative charge, which are originated from infinity. Another important fact about electric lines, origination and termination also we'll write down. And let's continue on the next sheet. Let's continue with the third characteristic of electric line of forces, which is an electric line of force, we can write, if originated, must require termination either on a negative charge or infinity. But you can also write that but the preference of termination for an electric line of force is toward a negative charge rather at infinity. Let's discuss this point with the help of an example. Like say we have a positive charge isolated from its surrounding, means there is no other charge present in the surrounding. That means it will originate electric lines in the surrounding in some specified quantity And as there is no negative charge in the surrounding, these electric lines will move up to infinity and finally these will terminate at infinity. On the contrary, say if we are having a positive charge and in its neighborhood we place a negative charge of same magnitude, like if it is plus Q, this is minus Q, that means the strength is same. It implies that it will originate some electric lines which will be proportional to the magnitude of charge. Later on we'll also prove it. And if it is originating and if it were isolated like we have discussed, these lines will be going to infinity. But if there is a minus Q charge placed in the surrounding, that implies what we have written conventionally, the preference of termination of an electric line of force is toward a negative charge rather at infinity. So whichever lines are originated from it, these are attracted by the negative charge and these will be terminated onto this negative charge. These lines will finally bend in this manner and finally these are terminating onto this negative charge. And as we have written, the magnitude of charge is exactly the same. The configuration of these electric field lines will also be symmetric in the situation like I am drawing here. So these all electric lines which are originated from the positive charge will be attracted by the charge and finally will terminate on minus Q. And with this convention we can also verify that still these electric line of forces are giving us the information about the net electric field of system. Like for example, we consider a point X on this electric line. Then we can see due to the positive charge at this point, electric field will exist in radially outward direction, which is E plus, and due to the negative charge it will exist in the direction of directed toward negative charge, which is E minus. Now if we draw the resulting electric field at this point X by the vector sum of these two electric fields, this will automatically come. The electric field at point X will come in such a way that its direction will be the tangent to the modified electric line in presence of these two charges. So this also verifies that electric line is giving an information about the net electric field of system. Many students generally get confused that as this electric line has originated from the positive charge, this will give info about the electric field of this charge, which is not true. We have already mentioned in the beginning of the section that total electric field information is given by the electric lines or the electric flux of the system. Now let's have a look on situations when the charges are not of equal magnitude, these are of different magnitude. Let's have a look on the situation in which there are two point charges given to us, in which one is plus 2q and other is minus q. As these are of unequal magnitude, here we can say that the electric line of forces which are originated from this charge will be double in quantity compared to this charge, because the strength of electric field due to this plus 2q charge will be more than this minus q. So in this situation, when electric lines are originated from the charge in its surrounding, as we already seen that we also studied that conventionally we consider that the preference of termination of electric lines is towards a negative charge. So in this situation, as a minus Q charge is placed nearby, these are attracted toward the charge minus Q, but not symmetric as compared to the previous case when the charges were of equal magnitude. Here the electric line strength or electric field strength of this plus 2Q will dominate that of minus Q. So in this situation we can say it will look like this situation which I am drawing here. These will not exactly be symmetric. In this situation the configuration of electric lines will be slightly shifted, or the overall orientation will be slightly shifted towards this negative charge, because it is smaller in quantity and this plus 2q is relatively more in quantity. So here we can see that the radial orientation of plus 2q will be less distorted and that of this minus q will be more distorted, because this is higher in strength. So if we further increase the magnitude of this charge and we decrease the magnitude of negative charge, the more radial orientation will exist in plus 2q, because this lower magnitude charge will be affecting less on it, and the radial orientation of this negative charge will be more distorted because this charge is higher in magnitude. Similarly, we can draw the field line configurations for similar polarity charges, like if there are two positive charges placed close to each other, then both of these will repel electric lines of each other, and rather than in radial direction, the configuration of electric field will exist like this. And symmetrically, these will exist if the charges are of equal magnitude. And if one charge is higher in magnitude, we can see that the field configuration will be dominating from the side of the charge which is higher in magnitude. So here I am drawing just approximately a symmetric configuration in which the charges are of similar magnitude. And say if we consider two charges where this one is plus 2q and this plus q, then we can see this charge will dominate the electric line configuration of plus q. So its configuration will be more distorted like this, and the configuration of this plus 2q will be relatively less distorted, or it will be almost radial. As the magnitude of charge will increase, you can simply state its configuration will be more radial like this. If this will increase, it will start dominating the other charge. This is the way how we can draw various electric field line configuration due to the electric field or flux originated from a charge.